Shaun of the Shed,
an AMI original podcast.
Hello and welcome back to another episode of Shaun of the Shed. I'm Shaun Preece and today I'm excited. I think what we're going to talk about today, what I'm going to show you today, is just going to be really cool for a lot of you out there. The smartphone has changed our lives, right? It enables us to do so many things as blind people that we couldn't do otherwise. But it's not the smartphone that does that, it's the apps. Apps are amazing, be it Seeing AI or Envision that allows us to read, let's say, printed text or even handwritten text for that matter, or Be My Eyes, allowing us to get sighted assistance through a video call, or using Be My AI feature, the ability to take a picture and get full detailed descriptions of whatever our camera sees. They're amazing. But did you know there's a way to supercharge apps on your iPhone? Yep, sorry Android users, I'm talking to iPhone users today, but honestly, this is just so cool and so convenient. So what am I talking about? Well, let's say, for example, a two-finger swipe to the right will take a picture and give you that full detailed description from Be My Eyes, but without you having to swipe through and open the app and get to the right place, it just does it automatically, just with one gesture. Or let's say a two-finger swipe to the left will start up Seeing AI and take you directly to the currency identifier or the color identifier or short text or whatever channel or feature you want to use. Again, all with one gesture. It's amazing. It makes apps even more convenient and easy to use. Now, the magic sauce, how you make this happen, is through something called Apple Shortcuts. Apple Shortcuts is a bit of a beast of an app, especially for voiceover users, and it can be a little bit daunting to use. But what I'm going to do today is walk you through step by step how to supercharge your apps and set up these feature gestures. And actually, it's pretty easy once you know what you've got to listen out for. So let's just jump straight into it. Let's supercharge our apps using Apple Shortcuts. So what the hell is Apple Shortcuts? Well, I'm glad you asked. Apple Shortcuts is just an app. Simple as that. Unless you've got a really old device, chances are Apple Shortcuts is already there right now on your iPhone. It's also available for the iPad, by the way, but I've never tried it. But hey, give it a go. Let me know how you get on. Now, the whole point of Apple Shortcuts is to create scripts. Now, already I know I'm losing lots of you already. Don't worry about this. As I mentioned, Apple Shortcuts is a beast of an app. There's just so much in it. And as a voiceover user, you know what? It's a little bit inconsistent. It's not a great experience, to be honest. But as I said, let's not worry about that. I'm not going to go through and show you what every single little thing does in Apple Shortcuts because, well, we'd be here for years. But what I am going to do is just show you step by step how to get this task done. And honestly, it is pretty straightforward once you know what you're listening out for. So, Apple Shortcuts, how do we open it? It will be on your home screen somewhere if you've got anything with iOS 13 or above. So just swipe through until you find Apple Shortcuts, or it may even just be called Shortcuts. I can't remember now. And double tap, or far easier, just ask Siri to do it. Say, Siri, open Shortcuts. Okay, so we're now in the Shortcuts app. Let me put my headphones on so I can hear my phone. The first thing we need to do is go to the very bottom of the screen.
Tab bar, automation, tab 2 of 3.
Now, at the bottom of the screen, you'll find, I think it's 3 tabs. The one we want to be in is the very first one, which is...
Selected, Shortcuts, tab 1 of 3.
Shortcuts. Now, again, I'm not going to go through everything here and explain what each thing does, but if you want to have a play around, feel free. You can't do any harm, really. I'm just going to double tap on Shortcuts, even though it says it's selected already.
Selected, Shortcuts, tab 1 of 3.
Cool. Now let's go right up to the top of the screen. To quickly jump up there, I'm going to tap on the top of the screen with 4 fingers.
Shortcuts, back button.
Okay. Now let's just swipe to the right with 1 finger until we hear...
All Shortcuts, heading. Select, button. Create Shortcut, button.
Create shortcut. That's what we want to do. Double tap.
Shortcuts. Back button. New shortcut one. Actions menu. Button.
Okay. Again, there's so much on here. But the one thing we want to listen out for, I will point out in just a second. I'm going to swipe through again with one finger to the right. But there's quite a few things. Here we go.
Done. Button. Actions. Create a shortcut. Add action. Button. Next action suggestions. Button. Next
Keep
action
going.
Suggestions. Open up. Button. Play music. Button. Actions controller. Minimized. Actions
That's...
available.
Thank you. That's what I'm listening out for. Actions controller minimized. Now let's double tap on that.
Actions controller. Half screen.
Half screen. That's not good enough. Trust me. Let's double tap on it again.
Actions controller. Full screen.
Full screen. That's what you want it to say. The reason I need full screen is because in half screen mode, I find that voiceover tends to get a little bit lost and the options change. So in full screen, we know exactly where we're at. Now we're here. Let's swipe through again.
Action library. Search for apps and actions. Search field.
Keep going.
Dictate button.
And again.
Selected categories button. One of two.
One of two. Swipe on.
Apps button. Two of two.
Apps. That's what we want. Let's double tap on that.
Selected apps. Two of two.
This apps category or apps tab, whatever you want to call it, will now show us a list of every app I've got installed on my iPhone. And we can choose one of these and then choose a function of one of those apps that we want to use. So let's have a quick look through. Again, swiping through.
Apps, one timer, button.
One timer, very cool.
Error Explorer, button.
Oh, of course.
Ergot, button. Amazon, button.
I'm just swiping through.
App Store, button. Audible, button. Be My Eyes, button.
Of course, that's our favorite, so... let's have a look what features we can use in here. Let's double tap.
Be My Eyes. Actions controller, full screen. Actions available.
Okay. Again, I'm just going to swipe through the options here.
Be My Eyes, heading. Close, button. Call volunteer.
Okay, nice, obvious. Next.
Ask question.
I don't know what a lot of these options do, but again, feel free to have a play. Try them out, see what they do. So I want to go to
describe fully.
Describe fully. So what this does is automatically takes a picture and gives you the most detailed description of it. Let's choose that one. I'm going to double tap.
Describe fully.
Now, once you double tap, it goes back to the previous screen. You don't need to do anything. All we're looking out for is at the top right corner of the screen.
Actions. Describe. Done. Button.
Done. There we go. Let's double tap on done.
Done. Shortcuts. Back button.
And now we're back where we started. If I swipe through.
All shortcuts. Heading. Select. Button. Create shortcut. Button. Search. Search field. Dictate. Button.
I'm still swiping through with one finger.
Describe with Be My AI. One action. Button. Actions available. Oh.
Describe with Be My AI. That's the shortcut we've just created. I know, we just created a shortcut. It was as easy as that. Now, to start that shortcut, activate it, I could simply ask Siri and say the shortcut name, Describe with Be My AI, and it would run that shortcut. But we're going to do more than that. As I mentioned right at the start, I want to assign a quick gesture to start that shortcut. And that's what we're going to do next. That was step one. Let's go on to step two. So we've created our first shortcut. That was fairly simple, wasn't it? And feel free to go through the list of apps that are available on your iPhone and see what you can do with them. There's really quite a lot in there. But anyway, we've created our first one. So what do we do now? Well, we need to go into our accessibility settings. So you can either swipe around until you find settings, double tap, and then swipe through to accessibility and double tap, or far easier, just ask Siri to open accessibility settings. Okay, so now we're in the settings app and we should be in the accessibility part. Let me just swipe through.
Accessibility heading.
Yes, we are. Now, what we want to go to is the voiceover option. So swipe through again, just swiping to the right with one finger.
Vision, heading, voiceover, on, button.
That's what I want, double tap.
Voiceover, switch button, on.
Now what I'm looking for is an option called commands. I'm just gonna swipe through, bear with me.
Voiceover speak, tap once to select, double tap to add, learn more, link, commands, button.
There it is, let's double tap on that.
All commands, button.
Actually, the very first item is the one that I want, all commands. Let's double tap on that.
Interaction, button.
Okay, now there's quite a few options in this list. The one I want is shortcuts, and actually it's right at the very end. So again, bear with me as I swipe on through.
Basic navigation, text navigation, advanced navigation, editing, button, rotor, button, scrolling, button, shortcuts, button.
There it is, double tap.
Describe with Be My AI, button.
And there it is, there's the shortcut that we created earlier. So that's the one I want to select, double tap.
Touch gestures, heading.
Now we've got a choice, we can assign that to a touch gesture. Let me just swipe on.
Add gesture, button. Keyboard shortcuts, heading.
Or you can assign it to a keyboard shortcut. So if you've got an external keyboard that you use with your iPhone, you can have a keyboard shortcut to trigger that shortcut. That could be quite cool, but I'm going to stick with a touch gesture. So I'm just going to swipe back just to the left with one finger.
Add gesture, button.
And again, I'm going to add a touch gesture. Let's double tap.
Cancel, button.
Oh, there's a lot of lists in this bit. So now if I swipe through.
Touch gestures, heading.
We're going to have a big list of all the touch gestures available on your iPhone. Now, one thing I will say is just be a little bit careful here. You don't want to assign this shortcut to a single finger double tap and lose the ability to activate anything. You can save yourself from this, but just be careful of what you're selecting. Now, I'm going to assign this shortcut to a two finger swipe to the right. I'm going to jump through this list by heading. So let me make sure I've got that selected.
Words. Speaking rate, 55% screen recognition, headings.
Headings. And now I'm just going to jump through this list and find the two-finger swipe gesture.
Tap, one finger, heading. Tap, two fingers, heading. Tap, three fingers, heading.
As you can hear, the list is broken up into the various gestures. This is the taps. I don't want that. I want swipes. Swipe down with one finger.
Tap, four fingers, heading. Swipe, one finger, heading.
Oh, nearly there.
Swipe, two fingers, heading.
That's what I want. Okay, so now let's just swipe through this list as we would normally.
Two finger swipe left. Two finger swipe right.
Two finger swipe right. Now, I'm going to double tap on this in a second, but I've already got something else assigned to two finger swipe to the right, and it will warn me about that. So let's have a quick look.
Triple tap the back of your iPhone. Two fingers alert, gesture in use.
Yes, it is.
The gesture is assigned to another command, move to next heading.
Now, normally I have the swipe left or right with two fingers to jump to previous or next heading. But for now, let's assign that shortcut to this gesture.
Cancel, button, assign, button.
Assign, double tap. And it's not telling me anything. Let's swipe around and see where we are.
Commands are prefixed with the voiceover modifier key. Commands are prefixed with the add keyboard shortcut button.
Oh, and we've finished and it's gone back to the previous screen. That's it. We are done. How easy was that? And of course, you could have gone through any one of those gestures in that list and chosen any one of them. There are quite a few gestures available that are not assigned to anything. Two finger, swipe left or right being one of them. But there's some gestures that you may never use. For example, is it a four-finger triple tap or a quadruple tap that brings on voiceover help? And I don't need that. But have a look through. Double check you are assigning it to the correct gesture and you're not getting rid of a gesture that you really need. But it is pretty straightforward. Now, come on, how cool was that? It opened the app, it took the picture and gave me the description without me having to swipe through a multiple amount of times. It just did it by performing one gesture. Now, if you think back to that list of apps, as I mentioned right at the start of this video, you can assign any gesture to pretty much any function of any app. So I do have Seeing AI, the short text feature to read my text of anything I've got in front of me, assigned to a gesture. I've also got another one for Voice Vista assigned to a back tap. That's something I should have shown you actually. If you go to Settings, Accessibility, and Touch, in there you'll find an option called back tap. Now you can assign a shortcut to either double tapping the back of your phone. I know, the back of your phone, weird. Or triple tapping the back of your phone, and that will activate a shortcut. It really is a really powerful feature, and it's just, it makes the smartphone just so convenient to use, especially if you've got a feature that you use all the time, such as taking a picture and getting a description. I hope that helped, and let me know how you get on with it. You can email me, Shaun@doubletaponair.com, or leave a comment below. If you liked this video, please hit that like button. And if you haven't done already, why not subscribe? Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.